Hey, it's Tin La from DIY channel. It's been a while. I'll make a video about my 3D printer, but today I'm gonna show you how I prepare my 3D printer for ABS printing. As you can see, I got some solution here. It's wood glue mixed with water, and I'm gonna apply it onto the heat bed. Let's see, I'm gonna show you how to do it. Alright, so I put it a little bit, so I don't want to see the consistency of that wood glue, and then use some straight edges to spread the solution out onto the bed. Right now the bed is very cool, about 30 degrees, so you just spread it like that. It's very hard for me to do by two hands. So there you go. It's very thin layer of the solution, basically wood glue and water. All right, I don't use hairspray or anything, because I used to use hairspray, but I got dizzy, I got nausea using that. When you heated up the hairspray, it's just terrible, you know. I couldn't even breathe inside the room, right? So you spread it out evenly like that, and then as when it's spread out, you can turn on the heat bed to like 50 degrees Celsius for this to dry. And there you go. Just as you can see, just enough to cover the whole bed. You don't want to apply it too much, right? Because when it dry, you know. So right now I'm gonna turn on my heat bed. So I put 110 degrees, so that's okay, because it takes a while to heat it up, the heat bed. So my bed is on, so it's gonna dry out. I'm gonna give a little bit more. My bed is very level, so you see the glue is not, you know, dripping onto one side. So I spread it out a little bit more. Just thin layer. I also use kind of glue stick, but it didn't really work for me. So this is the best thing that ever worked for me, is the wood glue with water. It's very safe. It's not like toxic when you heat it up, you know. So right now the bed is onto 50 degrees Celsius, and it's gonna dry out, and it leaves like a clear, transparent look. It's not like this. It's heating up, so you know. Wait for it. So some other the section here, you can see it's clearing right now, and into this portion of the heat bed will clear as well. So I'm gonna pause the video, and I'll show you later when it's all clear. Alright, okay, so as you can see, this portion of the solution is getting all clear, all dried up, and it leaves a very thin residue of glue, which is a wood glue on top of my glass. So right now the temperature is at 77 degrees Celsius. It's gonna climb up to 110, which gonna dry up all these water and leave some glue residue onto the glass. So alright, I'll come back later in about 2 or 3 minutes or something to get it all clear up, and I'm gonna show you how it's left off, okay?
Okay, welcome back in about 2 minutes. As you see, it become clear the solution, the wood glue and water solution become clear, thin layer of glue. So right now my heat bed is at 110 degrees Celsius for printing the ABS plastic. I have a little pool art, a little section of ABS left that I'm gonna print out and cover for my LED project. So I have it set up and ready to print. I'm gonna hit start print. So my printer is zero out, G28. So as I said before, I used to use hairspray, but it's not good, you know. It's releasing a lot of like toxic fume that makes me feel dizzy. So this is like this solution for the ABS. You can call it ABS juice or something, whatever. But you don't have to go and buy ABS juice. You can just use wood glue and water, mix them together like that, a very thin layer. I mean, a very thin solution. As you see, it's like a baby formula milk kind of viscosity. So my first layer coming on to the ABS juice. Oh, I gotta clear that thing out. Hopefully I can catch it with my hand. And as I say, it's I don't smell anything from the from this solution. I mean, with hairspray, oh my god, I cannot even smell. I mean, it's terrible smell. I don't know about ABS juice because I didn't want to pay like $10 to use the product. So I cannot really comment on the ABS juice. And I don't want to use acetone and then leftover ABS to mix into the solution. Acetone is, I don't know, it's a lot of smell. I mean, I wouldn't want to be around acetone for like a lot of time, you know? So this one doesn't even smell anything. And the print, it's just as good as ABS juice, I don't know. See? And as you see, my 3D printer, I rework on the, I used to have the RAM 1.4 bore here, but I moved it onto here. As you see. So I solder basically all the wire that I solder directly onto the board, because if I didn't, basically spark coming out and then it destroyed the board basically. It doesn't give me a lot of power, so I solder all heat bed wire directly to the board. So it really helps. And I also mount a power supply onto the printer itself. So let me show you the whole 3D printer from afar. So for some of you follow me since a couple of years ago, this 3D printer that I designed, I posted the source file, the SolidWorks file for this 3D printer you can view on Thingiverse. Now it's solid machine. I want to show you some more of the 3D printer. So I was having this machine for a long time. I put it on sale for like $1,000 on Facebook, but I think I'm gonna keep it and probably add a laser engraver function to it.
probably put it right here, you know, or put at the back to counter balance with the print head. So maybe put it at the back or something. The laser cutter, basically, it's, you don't need the Z axis to move. You need the fixed Z axis. So maybe mount directly onto this location here at the back here, and I add another print bed, bigger print bed onto this extension, and use different kind of material to cover this print plate, and use a laser engraver function to add it into my 3D printer. I think it's gonna work great, but so I'm ordering a laser engraver from China, and it soon will come here. But for now, I'm just using a 3D printer function to it. I'm gonna remove this. Oh, it's really clicked to it. Oh my God. Should have removed that earlier, but oh well. It's really bind to the, as you see, it's really bind into the heat bed, the glass material with that solution. I mean, I have no cover for ABS. This is ABS, right? I didn't even cover it because I printed at, let me see, I'll show you. I printed at 110 degrees Celsius for the bed temperature and the extruding at 260 degrees Celsius. As you see, I turn on the fan at 100%, which is not this fan. This fan's always works, right? 100% always works. But the other fan you see on the controller, which is this fan, to cool the fuse right here, the yellow big like capacitor here, I cool it down so it doesn't, the fuse doesn't blow during the print. So if you don't have it cool here, basically it can stop if the fuse got so hot. All right, so it's printed now. I'm gonna cut this video. I'm gonna show you later when the print is finished. Hey, welcome back to the print. Right now, it's almost over. Layer 15 or 16, so one more layer to go. And I want to show you that the it's not lifting up. The print is not lifting up from the heat bed. As you can see, I'll focus it right into the print. So it's still sticking up great to the heat bed glass material. So as you know, as I previously mentioned, that this solution that I mix with wood glue and water is so safe. It's not like acetone and ABS mixed together and you apply it onto the glass plate and it's gonna smell terrible in your room. I put my 3D printer in like my kitchen, so I don't want to have any weird smell to it. And as mentioned before, hairspray is also terrible for your print. Not terrible for your print, but terrible smell for your 3D printer. Basically, if you don't like the smell, so I think it's best for you to use wood glue and get water. Now the print is finished now. So there you go, guys. I hope that you like this video, and if you find the tip is useful for your situation, please give a like and subscribe to my channel, because I'm gonna be working a lot with this 3D printer from now on. Alright, so if you want to see more about this 3D printer and some upgrade, I want to do it to this one. So I'll see you guys in the next video, okay? Bye for now.
Oh, I forgot to mention that this print, when it finished, it stays like that. You don't want to remove the print from the heat bed. Just leave it as that, and then when the printer shut down, it will take some time for the heat bed to come down to like regular room temperature. And when it comes down, the print will basically pop up from the heat bed. So you don't have to do anything, just walk away from the print. After about 5 minutes or something, when it cool, the print itself will just release from the bed. You don't have to remove it. You don't have to force remove it from the heat bed. Okay? All right, see you, bye bye.